Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, fight fans. Welcome back. Let's just dig right into it. You know, the fight with Regis Prograe and Josh Taylor has led us to a potentially undisputed match against Jose Ramirez versus Josh Taylor, which in my opinion is a fantastic matchup. And we'll start with, you know, Jose Ramirez. He's stating that, you know, God has a plan for everyone, and God is, you know, God willing, mine will become the undisputed champion of the world. He looks to fight Josh Taylor very soon after he gets rid of his mandatory. That's a fight that he absolutely wants. He believes he can win, and he believes that's his destiny. And then on the other hand, you see Josh Taylor, after beating Regis Prograe, he called out Jose Ramirez. He feels like that is the fight of his career, and it will make him an elite pound-for-pound superstar. So you have to understand that a lot's on the line for both of these guys. So let's just break it down initially, our initial thoughts on everything. And we start with Jose Ramirez. Jose Ramirez is 25-0 with 17 knockouts. He has a 68% knockout rate. Jose Ramirez is 27 years old, so he's still young, and he's just barely on the cusp of getting to his prime, not quite there yet, so he still can get better. Jose Ramirez is 5'10" and has a 72.5-inch reach. That is in a massive reach and height for 140 pounds. And then you look at Josh Taylor on the reverse end. He's 16-0 with 12 knockouts. He has a 75% knockout rate. He's 28 years old, so roughly about the same age. He's 5'10", so roughly about the same height. Jose Ramirez does have a reach advantage over him because Josh Taylor has a 69.5-inch reach, but most people will consider that, you know, Josh Taylor other advantages as far as high ring IQ, ability to make different adjustments, will balance that out. And the way I see this fight is a very interesting one. You know, you see, you start with Jose Ramirez, and you see he's changed out of the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy. You know, he stopped Maurice Hooker in his last fight in 6 rounds. He unified the 140-pound titles at that point. He was the first one to do it. And training with Robert Garcia, Robert Garcia always has a top-level, elite-level game plan, and it's simply up to the fighters to execute it. You know, Jose Ramirez is a very talented fighter, and he spars with top-level fighters such as Mikey Garcia, such as Virgil Ortiz. So there's never a shortage of top-level fighters in their camp to spar, to prepare you for top level opposition. And that's one of the reasons why he's undefeated. He's looked so good in his fights, and that's one of the reasons why he's a unified undefeated champion at 140 pounds. And Josh Taylor, on the other hand, you know, just went through a top competition in the World Boxing Super Series, unified titles against Regis Prograe, you know, in a very close fight. But, you know, Josh Taylor won it clearly, but it was close. You know, you couldn't be mad that if it could have went either way. But at the end of the day, the majority of the people saw it, Josh Taylor just edging that fight. And that's a great fight and accomplishment for Josh Taylor. You know, not many people can beat a Regis Prograe. And, you know, so that was a very, very huge accomplishment that put him on many people's pound for pound list. So when we break down the fight versus Jose Ramirez versus Josh Taylor, we see, in our honest and unbiased opinion, that it's a 50-50 fight. Most people look at it and say, oh, Josh Taylor will just destroy Jose Ramirez. Oh, Jose Ramirez will just destroy Josh Taylor. I honestly don't think that anyone gets destroyed in this fight in any way. I think that this is a very close fight, similar to Regis Prograe, Josh Taylor, where it's going to be another 50-50 fight, because you see that Josh Taylor is going to play into Jose Ramirez's hands. You know, Josh Taylor is going to come forward. He's going to sit in the pocket and he's going to battle. And he's a very strong fighter, as we've seen. Jose Ramirez, on the other hand, is going to be an aggressive come forward fighter. And that makes perfect sense for Josh Taylor to be able to be countered. So this is going to be a fantastic fight. Both fighters play into each other's hands, and styles truly do make fights. So this is truly a 50-50 fight again, because you have two undefeated world champions, both massive size, both massive reach for 140 pounds. And both guys like to come forward. Both guys like to sit in the pocket, and both guys like the battle. Both guys take a lot of shots and punishment throughout the fights, and so this will be an extremely, extremely great fight. It'll be for undisputed, and I have it 50-50. I don't have a winner pick, because literally could go either way at this point. You know, we'll break it down and assess it as it gets closer to the fight, but as of right now, this is a 50-50 fight. Literally could go either way, and I don't think either guy dominates another. This will be yet another close thriller. But once again, unbiased as always, just IBFP. Please share, like, and you must absolutely subscribe.